Hello, everyone. Happy St. Patrick's Day from the National Civil War Museum. I'm Wayne Motts, the Chief Executive Officer here in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. And this is our captivating story of the American Civil War for March. And guess what? It's appropriate for today, March 17th. We're going to talk about Irish in the American Civil War. During the time of the Civil War, about 200,000 Irishmen served in the Civil War, about 180,000 in the Union forces, and about 20,000 in the Confederate forces. The most famous Irish-born Confederate soldier in the American Civil War was Major General Patrick R. Cleburne. And Cleburne was born March 16th, the day before St. Patrick's Day, in 1828. He was born just west of Cork. His father was a doctor. His mother died, unfortunately, when he was just 18 months old. He had a common school education there, and his father died when he was a teenager. He enlisted in the British Army when he was just 17 years old, and in 1849, he purchased his way out of the British Army and came to America. He went to New Orleans first, arriving in the United States. Then he went to Cincinnati, where he worked briefly in a drugstore, and then he settled in the frontier town of Helena, Arkansas. Now, in Helena, Arkansas, Cleburne really rose very quickly. This is a man that sat for the bar, became a prominent attorney, went into politics, became a partial owner of a newspaper. And before the American Civil War, he was elected captain in the Yell Rifles, a militia group there. When the Civil War broke out, he became the colonel of the 1st Arkansas Infantry Regiment in the Confederate forces during the American Civil War. He fought in the Kentucky Campaign. And by 1864, Patrick Cleburne is a major general, one of only two foreign-born men who reach and attain the rank of major general in the Confederate Army at the time of the American Civil War. Cleburne had an interesting view. In January 1864, he wrote a letter to Joseph E. Johnston, the Confederate commander in that area, and he purported that the Confederate forces should arm African Americans and that slaves should be free for Confederate service. A very radical view at that period of time, and that really ended Cleburne's career or possibility for promotion. He's in the military, and in November of 1864, he is part of the campaign with General John Bell Hood in the state of Tennessee. At the Battle of Franklin, Tennessee, on November 30th, 1864, Patrick Cleburne will lead a Confederate division attacking Union works at the Carter Plantation and Gin location. And while he's there, he will be mortally wounded. Before this assault, General Hood gave the orders for the men to go forward, and Cleburne said, "I will take the works or die in the attempt." Cleburne had two horses that were shot out from under him in that assault. He was mortally wounded 50 to 60 yards from the Union works around the Carter House. His body was identified. It was taken to the Carton Mansion along with three other Confederate generals, and it was placed out on the mansion porch. It was buried locally. And then, very interesting, only a week before his death, he had passed through Ashland, Tennessee. He saw a beautiful Episcopal chapel called St. John's Episcopal Chapel, and he said, "This place is so beautiful, it's almost worth dying for." And a week later, he's killed at Franklin, and his body is buried at St. John's Episcopal Chapel in Ashland, Tennessee. Ironically, a chapel that he had passed, killed later, and buried there, but it was also built and constructed by Leonidas Polk, who was killed in the American Civil War as a Confederate general. Now, eventually, Cleburne's body is taken to Helena, Arkansas, and that's where it rests today. He was just 36 years old when he died in the American Civil War. Like so many immigrants looking for opportunity in the 1840s and 50s, Patrick Cleburne came to the United States. He found that opportunity, and his life was cut short on November 30th, 1864, at the Battle of Franklin. I hope you've enjoyed this captivating story of the American Civil War on this day, St. Patty's Day. And we ask you, if you like this video, please go and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Look at all the video presentations the museum has there. Thanks, and have a great day.